conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, Lord, for your grace and joy. As we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion that we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a shout to him in songs.
For the Lord is a great God,
and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands are moulded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our God. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture,
and the sheep of his hand.
Oh, that today we would hearken to his voice.
The earth is the Lord's, for he made it.
Come, let us adore.
Psalms 41 and 52. Happy are they who consider the poor and needy. The Lord will deliver them in time of trouble.
The Lord preserves them and keeps them alive so that they may be happy in the land. He does not hand them over to the will of their enemies.
The Lord sustains them on the sickbed and ministers to them in their illness.
I said, Lord, be merciful to me. Heal me, for I have sinned against you.
My enemies are saying good things about him. When he died, his name perished.
Even if they come to see me, they speak empty words. Their heart collects false rumours. They go outside and spread them.
All my enemies whisper together about him and devise evil against me.
A deadly thing they say has fastened on him. He has taken to his bed and will never get up again.
Even my best friend, whom I trusted, who broke bread with me, has lifted up his heel and turned against me.
But you, O Lord, be merciful to me and raise me up, and I shall repay them.
By this I know you are pleased with me, that my enemy does not triumph over me.
In my integrity you hold me fast, and shall set me before your face forever.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel. From age to age, Amen. Amen. You tyrant, why do you boast of wickedness? Against the godly all day long.
You plot ruin. Your tongue is like a sharpened razor, a worker of deception.
You love evil more than good, and lying more than speaking the truth.
You love all words that hurt. Oh, you deceitful tongue.
Oh, that God would demolish you utterly, topple you and snatch you from your dwelling, and root you out of the land for the living.
The righteous shall see and tremble, and they shall laugh at him, saying,
this is the one who did not take on, but trusted in great wealth and relied upon wickedness.
But I am like a green olive in the house of God. mercy of God for ever and ever.
I will give you thanks for what you have done, and declare the goodness of your name in the presence of the godly. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel. Chapter 4, beginning at verse 1. When Saul returned from following the Philistines, he was told, David is in the wilderness of En-Gedi. Then Saul took 3,000 chosen men out of all Israel and went to look for David and his men in the direction of the rocks of the wild goats. He came to the sheepfolds beside the road where there was a cave, and Saul went in to relieve himself. Now David and his men were sitting in the innermost parts of the cave. The men of David said to him, "Here is the day which the Lord has said to you, I will give your enemy into your hand, and you shall do to him as it seems good to you." Then David went and stealthily cut off a corner of Saul's cloak. After David was stricken to the heart because he had cut off a corner of Saul's cloak, he said to his men, "The Lord forbid that I should do this thing to my Lord, the Lord's anointed, to raise my hand against him, for he is the Lord's anointed." So David scolded his men severely and did not permit them to attack Saul. Then Saul got up and left the cave and went on his way. Afterwards, David also rose up and went out of the cave and called after Saul, "My Lord, my the king." When Saul looked behind him, David bowed with his face to the ground and did obeisance. David said to Saul, "Why do you listen to the words of those who say, 'David seeks to do you harm'? This very day, your eyes have seen how the Lord gave you into my hand in the cave, and some urged me to kill you, but I spared you. I said, 'I will not raise my hand against the Lord, for he is the Lord's anointed.' See, my father, see the corner of your cloak in my hand. For by the fact that I cut off the corner of your cloak and did not kill you, you may know for certain that there is no wrong or treason in my hands. I have not sinned against you, although you were hunting me to take my life. May the Lord judge between me and you. May the Lord avenge me on you, but my hand shall not be against you. As the ancient proverb says, 'Out of the wicked comes forth wickedness,' but my hand shall not be against you. Against whom has the king of Israel come out? Whom do you pursue? A dead dog? A single flea? May the Lord therefore be judge and give sentence between me and you. May he see to it and plead my cause and vindicate me against you." When David had finished speaking these words to Saul, Saul said, "Is this your voice, my son David?" Saul lifted up his voice and wept. He said to David, "You are more righteous than I, for you have repaid me good, whereas I have repaid you evil. Today you have explained how you have dealt well with me, in that you did not kill me when the Lord put me into your hands. For who has ever found an enemy and sent the enemy safely away? So may the Lord reward you with good. Good for what you have done to me this day. Now I know that you shall surely be king, and that the kingdom of Israel shall be established in your hand. Swear to me, therefore, by the Lord, that you will not cut off my descendants after me, and that you will not wipe out my name from my father's house." So David swore this to Saul. Then Saul went home, but David and his men went up to the stronghold. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Song of Moses. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider has he hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Saviour. This is my God, and I will praise him. The God of my people,